never heard anything from you, when we're in government or when we're in opposition. And therefore, whatever plans we have in relation to this, we will divulge that information in due course, but we would want to discuss it with the other members of the parliamentary group and other individuals who are candidates or prospective candidates, as we are aware, but I would not want to ventilate such here in this kind of forum. But we really appreciate all that you have done and all that you are doing to help to sensitize the public about Barbados, whether it's good or bad, so that we can all come together and make a difference, because the children are watching and the rest of Barbados is relying on Barbadians at all levels to be able to build this country and give us the hope and the dignity to be able to become worthwhile citizens at the end of it all. And the kind of strategic planning that took place when it came to projects and communication with the Ministry of Finance and indeed the public administration department. If you want to get more teachers in the system, you don't just say, come on and work. You bring your sister, you bring your brother, your cousin, as this government does with the families first. We made sure that the funding was there and that there was a justifiable reason why new teachers need to come into the systems, or janitors or general workers, whatever. So I am sitting in because I too am extremely concerned about what is happening to the people in St. Thomas. I left about 15 Allen school children at one bus stop there, Richmond Hall, at minutes to 10 o'clock this morning, no school bus. No school bus. And then every time you walk the streets, you don't have to put down your records. Every time you walk the streets, a bus is broken down, it's behind open. And people in Sturgis have no bus, except one at 6:30 in the morning. So you're talking about hundreds of people in a constituency that has more than 900 members of the electorate, not mentioning the young people and the little children. And it really is a very hurtful thing. I must tell you, this tribalism in this country now under this government, I've never seen it. It reminds me of Jamaican things I heard about Jamaica. Because you're in opposition, so you can't get a bus service to run.
Thank you.
Or you can't get a post office open. My post office shut, the fire service move. Rockhampton Road, since January 2008, they didn't get a quart of bitumen on it yet.
Good.
We had our own discussions in our parliamentary party group up to yesterday evening we met. Because we believe that the business of the people of Barbados is paramount. But I want to speak to the whole content of this press conference and to question how does a person responsible for the management of a ministry leave a country when there are so many challenges in that ministry? We have that big problem at Brissett School. We have the University of the West Indies problem. We have children in our schools who have no textbooks at this time because of the economic situation where parents have lost their work, or they're on 3-day week, or so many other challenges. 2-3 people in a house being sent home, most of them from the government sector. We have school needs in shambles where almost every day it is macaroni mixed with something, and we're talking about the nutrition of our children. How does a minister leave a country with those matters hanging? And I think that is basically what Eddie is saying. How do you set up them in the minds of people that there is hope to be able to receive bursaries, and then nothing has happened after more than 5 months? I think it is unfortunate that the accountability, the transparency, the trust, the equity that we speak about, and of course that would have been enshrined in the manifesto of the Democratic Labour Party, particularly in 2008, and Barbadians bought it, and they have no problem with that, because if people come out and make you promises of that nature and you vote for them, then you expect them to deliver. But I have a serious problem when a minister, an honorable minister, makes a promise to the public of Barbados that grants will be, or 3,000 students will be able to benefit for the funds for their pursuance through the University of the West Indies. How does a minister do that without a budget? Because in order for you to make plans, I may have had some experience, in order for you to make plans of that nature, you have to have a budget. If you want to put a parent volunteer program, you have to have a budget. If you want to make sure that the quality of the meals and the services at school meals are upgraded, you have to have a budget. If you want to bring in psychological services to look after the needs of those children who are going through trauma, some of them are on drugs, you have to have a budget. How is it that a minister cannot speak of a budget to be able to give that hope a reality for these students to be able to go through? So the tutors at the university are concerned, because when their classes are now 3 times smaller, or when classes have to be canceled because only 6 people have applied in some faculties, then how do you treat to that? And it really hurts to know that there's so many parents who have been relying on this education through the tertiary level, particularly University of the West Indies, to help lift some of them out of poverty. When my first sister went to university, we thought that we had received gold, because we knew here it is, the family is now going to be able to take a hold on the social and emotional situations and climb the social ladder. And I think a lot of people's thoughts are being dashed. I am concerned that when you look at how much money was spent in the Alexandra School investigation, that was money that was wasted, almost $1 million. When you look at the situation where 72 guard huts were built and not a single security guard, because there was no proposal for the public administration to be able to say, let us give you security guards, and those huts are falling apart. That is the kind of funding that I'm talking about that would have been taken and used to help these university students to pay. And if there's a time more than ever that these university students need the financial grants, it is now, because 3,500 young people who come out of secondary school every year, many of them can't go to the polytechnic anymore. There's no money. Many of them can't pursue their dreams through the community college because of limited funds. Even the skills training programs have been scaled down, and our young people are out there languishing because they need some kind of barometer to guide them to be able to achieve the dreams and the goals that they have set. So I have a tremendous difficulty with the minister going to China at this time, and indeed the heavy travel that is happening across the island at the cabinet level, when we have so many serious issues, social and otherwise, on the ground that require answering. The opposition cannot come up all the time and be in people's faces, because we've done it so many times in almost every sphere of what has been happening since 2008. And then you hear they want to incite violence. When the minister came out and talked, few people criticized him about the crackhead and so. But we were trying to see how best we can get Barbadians to understand there is another way to do things. We did our rubbing shoulders. And the rubbing shoulders project, for me, is one of the best projects that you can be able to hear the voice of the people and have to point them in directions. And we have been doing, we have worked on quiet projects to help people through the rubbing shoulders to be able to make a living. We've talked to the vendors, we've shown them ways of which they can be able to make a viable living. Now they have lost their employment. But I have a serious problem in building up the hopes of the youth, dashing them, and then not coming back to say a single word. And a parliamentary secretary has to come to speak for a distinguished minister who has been there for all these years. It is wrong, and we need to get our act right in Barbados if the electorate, if the public is supposed to give us that element of respect and trust that is due and that we have grown accustomed to. It really is not happening in the way we would like it, and therefore we as an opposition will speak out against what we consider to be wrong in the way we treat the people and how we destroy the hopes that they have had to be able to survive as a people. The minister's comments are always very insulting. I consider his approach to be, in my words, not the best in speaking to people and making them feel comfortable in his presence with some of the snide remarks that he makes. And I think it is about time that we, especially persons of my kind and the honorable minister's kind, who have been in the teaching system, who are to be setting the examples for others to follow. If a teacher can't do it, or a priest can't do it, I do not see anybody else who can capture the respect that any person that says, I have been a teacher, and I'm not questioning the minister's character, but if you say you're a teacher, you must be able to better communicate and make people feel comfortable in your presence. And then when you give that word, that your word is your bond, but not just talking and using the rhetoric for rhetoric's sake. I think it is wrong, and we in the Barbados Labour Party are totally against it. We want the accountability, the transparency, the trust and the equity to be at the forefront, as justice is not only done but seen to be done, because it is the young people and their parents and the expectations that we all have that we want to see go from strength to strength in the interest of every Barbadian soul.